And, of course, not every category is growing on online. So you see, for example, the online share for netbook is declining because there are more and more normal consumer, less innovative, which are simply going into the shop. They like to see the products, they like to get some basic explanations, and therefore, online is an alternative. It's a part of the market. It's not taking over the market. It's just one part and one element. It's also offering consumer choice. What we are seeing currently, onliners are changing their pricing strategy. Of course, there is always a better and cheaper price available in the web, but a lot of onliners are slowly focusing and start to focus on premium products. Of course, the advertisement is quite price aggressive. They like to get certain attraction. They like to bring people on the pages. But often these products are also related to lower specs. And therefore, onliners are changing behavior currently. Be aware of it. Check in your countries whether it's taking place and how it's taking place. Onliners are often addressing innovators and sometimes cozy people. It's a question how you can bring innovators with some kind of event shopping, maybe in the outlets. The advantage of online is there is a clear, broad assortment available. And this assortment, even if it's only virtual, is often attracting consumer because it's a quite nice shopping experience in the beginning just to have a look what's available. And of course, there is no distribution gap. The products are always there. It's not like sometimes in a shop you're going in and you're not finding it. And in a certain way, it seems that products are available 24 hours, 7 days a week. Onliners will face a certain challenge. They are concentrating quite strongly. This means we are expecting further on a concentration because consumers are not able to remember hundreds and thousands of web pages, so they have to focus. And of course, onliners will see much more seasonal effects. The seasonality is coming also into the online business. The real advantage of the traditional channel is there are real products. And nowadays, you saw by far more than 80%, and this is an average value for all the categories, are still buying in the retail channel because just getting the product right away is important to a lot of consumers. So this product availability on shelf is one of the key issues, and therefore from our understanding, especially having products on shelf is quite important for every retailer. The consequence, you see it around the globe, a lot of retailers are investing in big technical superstores, and these big technical superstores offering choice are in the end winning a lot of consumers. The last 3 minutes, a couple of comments for the year to come. We are used in IT especially to make real technology products and often technology statements. I was in France, and maybe it's a France example, but it's illustrating on one side you see here a very technical statement. You have to pay for 5 minutes or you have to pay after 5 minutes. So typical IT approach, very strict, very detailed, a number, but at least in France there is also a marketing approach. Kiss and fly. So you have more or less in white and in yellow two times the same statement, and it's an illustrating for power of wording, for power of marketing. And this is becoming much, much more important because prices are coming more and more closer together. Features are coming closer together. Therefore, what for example Antoine was telling yesterday, this branding, this bringing the brand via retailers to consumer is one of the key issues for future business from our understanding. Of course, products are starting to be commoditizing functions with a lot of applications, easy to run. You can make out of a mobile phone, a camera, an MP3 player, a radio, a clock radio, a calculator, a navigation system, and in principle it's not ending. You can use it as boarding pass, as lighter, as cookbook, whatever you like. this is going on, and consumers will need a certain advice, what is the main purpose, because sometimes consumers are simply lost. So a clear positioning of product, besides the opportunities that products can do a lot of things that are just digital, is quite important from our understanding too. There is a lot of buzzwords. Everybody is talking about cloud. Wherever you are looking, you are finding meanwhile these nice pictures. They are all symbolizing a cloud, and depending on where you are looking, the names and the buzzwords are just changing. Of course, this cloud is simply taking place because internet network is available. Every device sooner or later has the possibility to be connected to this cloud. So whatever you connect, it's quite likely that there is some access possible and there is some content available. The basic for connecting is hardware. So hardware is key for using whatever online content you like to get. Hardware is key for accessing the cloud, and certain cloud concepts are quite questionable. Two examples, just have a look on hard disk drive space, external hard disk drive. If you buy a 1 terabyte drive, it's around about 70, 80 euro. You are using a drive for 5, 6, 7 years. So if you are dividing these 70, 80 euro by 7, 8 years, by 12 months a year, the cost for 1 terabyte for the consumer is around about 1 euro per month, or $1 per month. This means if somebody is willing to offer in the cloud online storage 1 terabyte, if it's more than $1, 1 euro a month, for the consumer it's much more cheaper to buy the drive instead of using it online. Another example, if you're looking on all these apps for mobile phones, 30-40%, depending on how you're counting it, are already free right now. Consumers are trying, consumers are choosing. The market is so attractive that companies are bringing more and more of these apps online for free. So it's a quite interesting market, it's a quite challenging market, but in the end there is no money. It's coming back to hardware, because you simply need hardware. And this is the huge chance for the future. Just have a look on all the social media. Whatever consumers might do, live streaming, social shopping, collaboration, blog search, working with blog communities, going to forums, looking for certain location-based services for video streaming or whatever, hardware is needed. And because there is so much online content available, more and more hardware devices will be needed. The simple calculation, you can segment the market by inch size. It's starting with 3, 4, 5 inch with smartphones, and it's ending up with 17, 19 inch with portables, with desktop replacement notebooks. And because there is so much content available, people like to get online wherever they are. These products are diversifying even further on, and there was simply one gap, around about 7, 8, 9 inch, and you see Apple or mobile internet devices is closing this gap. This means hardware and in consequence peripheral is bringing a lot of opportunities for the next year to come, because there will be more and more online content available, and people, consumers, are simply like to use this online content. Therefore, teamwork is necessary. Individual play the game, but team win championships. I wish you a lot of success here these days, these couple of days, in teaming up and deciding and making successful business for the next quarters to come. Thank you.